grab a bottle of this. See what you guys think. It's interesting. And leave comments down below. I'd really like to hear your thoughts on this because I can't freaking figure it out to save my life. Welcome to Whiskey is a Journey. My name is Peter Fasciano. And in today's journey, we're going to head out of the Isle of Islay and we're going to head over to, I believe, the mainland around the Speyside area. And we're going to be taking a look at the Craigellachie distillery or the Dewars and Sons distillery. I'm not too sure which one it is. But while we're there, we're going to take a look at the Craigellachie 13. Let's go ahead and pour it, nose it, taste it, and talk about it. Craigellachie is coming in at 46% ABV. We're looking at non-chill filtered, natural color. This is a 750 milliliter bottle. I'm in Phoenix, Arizona, and this is coming in at $48.49 at the time that I purchased it. Let me take a second here and ask you guys to like, subscribe to the channel. This is my Monday series where I'm taking a look at a mini series of individual whiskeys, whether it be my age stated single malt scotches or my previous series on the single malt Irish American single malts. And then coming up on my Monday mini series, I'm gonna be doing some rye Japanese whiskeys and then also take a look at some Irish single pot stills. So let me know down in the comments below which one you guys wanna see next, Irish, Japanese, rye, or maybe something else that I haven't thought of yet. Let me know in the comments down below. Also, go ahead and turn on that bell notification. Give me a like if you're so inclined. And if you know anybody in the whiskey world that would be interested in this content, why don't you go ahead and share it with them? All right, let's go ahead and get onto the nosing on this. I've had this whiskey before, and my first reaction to this was, this is a Speyside? What in the actual what is in this glass? This is so much different than other Speysides. I know Speysides do have a wide range of sweetness and they don't typically have to fit into the Speyside profile. But for some reason, this one seems to be a beast all on its own. It's interesting and I really do like the nose on this. There's a sweetness to it and it's not a fruit sweetness, it's a vegetal sweetness. It almost reminds me of the St. George, the American single malt out of San Francisco, I believe it is. I also get a little touch of pepper on here. A black pepper, not a white pepper. So there is spice to this. And there's definitely something else in here that I can't quite put my finger on. And it's that undiscovered note or undefinable note that keeps me coming back to this individual whiskey and I can't put my finger on it. It's almost a smoke, but not really. Let's go and do the first taste. That first sip is a little bitter. It's good. And I get some wood notes to it, all very, very good. That note that I can't pinpoint on the nose is also showing up on the palate. If I had to hazard a guess, I would say some sort of minty flavor. But you can never trust the first sip, so let's go and go for a second sip. I'll tell you what, this does not lack flavor in any way. This is definitely a whiskey that you can sit down, talk about it, try to dissect. And at this point in my journey, I can't pinpoint exactly what it is that I'm getting on the nose and the taste, but it's fantastic. Not a beginner whiskey. I get earthy, minty, vegetal sweetness, a little bit of pepper, and again, that undefined note. Can't figure it out. You know, this just dawned on me. Springbank has a very unique flavor in Campbelltown. If Springbank were to be making a Speyside, I think that would kind of come across in this. This is not your typical Speyside offering, and it's just different enough to keep it separated from everything else. Let's get a couple of drops of water in here and see if it does anything. I add water to all of the whiskeys. Doesn't make a difference what it is. So let's see if this changes the profile at all. A couple of drops will do. Get the glass coated and talk a little bit about Craigellachie and the whiskey itself. That finish is just going on and on. It's a pretty long finish, almost reminiscent of a smoky finish. So the distillery was built in 1891. The word Craigellachie means rocky hill, and I believe this is on a bluff overlooking the Spey River, maybe the confluence of the Spey and another river. I'm not sure which one it is. I'll put it right here. And the spirit that they produce in Craigellachie is mainly in the Dewars blends, but Craigellachie also has multiple offerings. They have the regular 13. They also have a 13-year-old that's finished in Armagnac casks. So they have two 13 offerings, they have a 17, and then they also have a 23-year-old. And one of the unique things about Craigellachie is they use a worm tub, so they have their spirit really contacting that copper as it's going through and recondensing, which offers a different type of flavor. And then again, just that little bit of a difference might be the difference between a standard Speyside and what they're offering here. And the last thing is the ownership. And I really need help on this. I'm still confused on how there is there's an ownership of Bacardi on this, but there is a subsidiary company called the Dewar and Son Company. And I'm not exactly sure how that works, how Bacardi is the overarching company, but then the individual distillery is owned by somebody else. Leave some comments down below on if you guys understand that dynamic between parent company and subsidiary. Let's get onto the nose with the water. See if it's changed it at all. Immediately, I still get that vegetal sweetness. That undefined note is still there. Maybe it's a floral, minty, smoky, all combined together with wet earth. I'm just totally confused on that note. I can't pinpoint it. If you guys are familiar with Craigellachie 13 and you know that note, and if you're confused by the notes as well, leave some comments down below. Let me know what you guys think. Let's get to the taste with the water. The water significantly changed the spiciness. This is now a spice bomb on my tongue. And that minty note comes out again. Very long finish. It just goes and goes and goes. It doesn't necessarily open up to anything different. You still get that same exact undefined. I'm still getting that same exact undefined note. But it radiates and it elevates and it just builds and builds, falls away. I have some nice wood tannins on the side of my tongue. That pepper note lingers. A little hint of smoke and a little hint of mint. Very interesting, like I had mentioned before. Let's get a second sip with the water in. All right, unchanged. Everything's still the same. But that finish is now leaving my mouth with a very clean feeling. The mint is still there, the pepper is still there, but it's a very refreshing cleanliness. I like that quite a bit. All right, let's go ahead and get on to the rating, and then we'll call this video good. My rating system is out of 5 stars. Because this whiskey is so incredibly complicated, and it reveals a lot, and you can dissect it, and the flavor is really good. I can see this dominating a conversation. Every time you go back to it, I think you might find a little bit more, and that intriguing portion of the whiskey has to be involved in the rating system. Because of the notes that are in here, because it's so interesting, I'm gonna go ahead and rate this one a 4.25. I find this fascinating. I find it interesting. I find it welcoming, but also challenging. 4.25 for me on this one. Seems reasonable. All right, so that's where I'm going to leave it. Again, if you guys are not subscribed to the channel and you're liking this information, why don't you do me a favor and subscribe? If you know somebody in the whiskey world that would be interested in this content, share it with them. And while you're at it, turn on that bell notification because I'm starting to produce videos Monday, Wednesday, and the first Friday of every month. If all of that sounds interesting to you guys, stick around. Enjoy your journey. We'll talk to you guys next time. Bye.